Davina Henton claimed the Delano Pole Award for her home race after qualifying was very wet. Zelda Ashby in the 55 car for FPO starts on the outside of the front row, and Melanie Cleveno in third. I don't think anyone would have expected any of those three cars to qualify in the top third of the field, really, because they hadn't shown the speed in the dry. We'll have to wait and see, though, how things turn out. After the round of Georgia, the two Terra International Motorsports cars driven by Nick Dawson and Ike Durbin were disqualified after both cars failed post-race tech inspection. They were given last place points for the Independence Trophy as a result. Last time out at Road Atlanta, there were only four cars in the field that were in with the promoter's option. Here at Brands Hatch, there are six cars in with the promoter's option, bringing the car count up from 38 to 40. With that being said, there's some very interesting new faces that have begun to show up, as you see Ben Horan, one of them, showing up. Across the ticker there, Avery Holtzman is in the third to Tino. And a little further back, you notice also some very strong names at the back of the field that we may not be used to seeing back here. On race day, it started to rain. Dan, off to you. Thank you, Lance. The weather forecast called for light rain during the race. However, this is not exactly what I was expecting when I heard the words light rain. As you see, Davina Henton doesn't get as good of a getaway as Zelda Ashby in that 55 car. Henton's driving the Lynx L313, and Zelda Ashby driving the FPO 9000 car there. The Terminator car, that's the old Terminator project that ran in Indy last year. But both those cars are new for this season, and Yamino Tenchi, who's moved her way up into fourth, is driving an Omeka MA04. They were supposed to be running this race with their own Clockwork Midnight car. They should have that car ready to go for the Cariola Grand Prix. That is, of course, the Clockwork Racing car that I'm talking about. Anyways, as the two Lynx cars, first and third, Chris Johans goes around in the background, further back in the field, after contact with Avery Holtzman. It looked like Packer Carroll stuck it in three wide. That was way too ambitious, I think, as Holtzman was squirreling all over the place in that 48 car. Now here's you have Jenny Kuznetsov in the number 8 car. The very popular Russian driver just kind of throws it.
You guys said that was Packer? Well, tell him I'm sorry for minding my own business, I guess.
Well, as I was saying there, Kuznetsov kind of threw it off all by himself. Ian Cooper, car number 777, who owns the Clockwork Racing team, he's in trouble early. He's reporting he has no fourth or fifth gear in that Team EFR car. He's holding up Luciano Savarol and causing quite a bit of a stack-up back here. Not quite sure. He's trying to hold a line and get out of everyone's way, but they just don't seem to want to pass him. Interesting. Zelda Ashby in the 55 car moves around Davina Henton to take over the lead as Cleveno tries to strike, but not close enough. Melanie Cleveno, car number 12, is trying to look on Davina Henton there, but Zelda Ashby in that 55 car has not won in a while. Hasn't won in the rain, as far as I can recall, so... Ashby in that 55 car having a great run so far in driving for FPO. She's really had the advantage over Ebenezer Quiggles Jr., something that shouldn't be that much of a surprise. But anyways, further back in the field, we got a big wad of cars, a lot of Independent Trophy cars back here, along with the Tutino of Alessandro Rossini and the two Nemotos who have been having a disastrous weekend. That's Bart Sandy in the 05 car. We were just looking at. Interesting paint job there. Here's Yamino Tenchi in the 25 car, as I mentioned. This team has their own Midnight chassis that they're working on. We're supposed to bring it here, but they opted not to do that because they hadn't had a chance really to test it. They're going to be bringing it out for the Cariola Grand Prix, and that's a bit of a first test session. That might not be a good idea. We'll have to see how that goes. The Ian Cooper owned car is being attacked by Adrian Devereaux in car number 1. As the reigning series champion Devereaux moves around Yamino Tenchi around the outside. Tenchi slides and almost wipes it out. It's really beginning to come down a little harder. Rain tires or not, things are getting very interesting out there as we're looking at Cameron Taylor, one of the heroes of this race last season. He wasn't running very well last year, but he still managed to pick up a good result. He's actually been driving a lot better than he was last year. Really came on in the second half of the Independence Trophy and during the Team Light season. Driving for Team Timothy, the same team he runs for in Team Lights. He came close to winning the Team Lights Championship last year. As we're now looking deep in the field, and who are we looking for here? I think we're looking for Michael Sykes, because I can see him right there in that the red 5 car behind Packer Carroll and Luciano in the emerald green 3 cars back there. Yep, there's Michael Sykes in the red 5, the Welshman, driving for Alert. One of the few races where he's... do believe he's been outqualified by Chris Davenport for the second time in a row. So, interesting there. As Melanie Klevino begins to work on Davina Hinton. Hinton really sliding around now. So you can see Hinton has been holding up this group of cars back here as Klevino goes by. The Swiss driver who won in New York last year, Hinton slides it wide in the last corner. Adrian Devereaux says thank you very much. Moves up into third. Roderick is going to try to peek around Hinton as well. Judging by the practice speeds, Adrian Devereaux seemed to be in a league of his own. So it didn't look like anyone really had anything for him in practice. And, hopefully Adrian Devereaux is not going to make things a little bit too uninteresting, because sometimes Adrian Devereaux, once he gets out front, the race is almost over for the battle for the win, at least. But here he comes around Melanie Klevino. Klevino's trying to fight it, but Adrian Devereaux just really stuck his nose in there and made it work. Adrian Devereaux, the two-time reigning series champion, has 13 wins to his credit. Arto Kekkonen slides off from eighth. I don't think the Gessler team got their wet setup working in race conditions. So, Arto Kekkonen is not exactly having the best of times out there in that 9 car. There's Chris Davenport in the yellow 6 car. The car directly behind him, that silver and blue car, that is the Huntley. This is Huntley's first start of the year. They're having an independent trophy run with Ben Huron. They're running in 23rd, and here's Ben Huron. This is the farthest that they've ever made it in race conditions, the Abbey Engineering Huntley. Because in Huntley's only previous start, they went out in the first lap. So, in a spectacular incident, I might recall, at Decatur at the end of last year. But they're doing Huntley's doing a good job, and so is Ben Huron, the Welsh driver. Is very familiar with this racetrack, so a good place for him to make his debut. His debut for his Independence Trophy campaign, second career start. Anyways, Leonard Roderick slides off the track in car number 4. That's a bit of an interesting mistake for Roderick to make. I wasn't expecting it. Roderick, of all people, to be one of the first people to slide into that tire barrier over there. Here's two drivers that I think people are expecting some good things from. Ebenezer Quiggles Jr. and Greg Woodard are both pretty good rain drivers, and they've both been pretty quick this weekend. They're running 14th and 15th, and granted, they don't have the best machinery at their disposal. And despite what people say that the rain is the great equalizer, I don't really buy that personally, but... despite what people say, I think we should look for these two cars in particular. They don't have the best cars in the field, but I do believe these are two of the hotter prospects for the future. And here is Cameron Taylor. I think he got bumped off by Chris Davenport, and Ben Huron slides right into him. It looked like Huron was just trying to not pile into that and ended up sliding and piling into it anyway. I don't think he got help from... No way. You did not get help from Packer Carroll, so... I was just making sure that, Lewis Kingston, the 17, was way sideways. There's Matthias Taub, a rejuvenated Matthias Taub. And the four-time world champion, Peter Short. As Short goes wide and just barely misses the tires. As Gaspar D'Souza in the background actually slides into him, I do believe. So, Matthias Taub working for it as Michael Sykes slides off. And Luciano Savarola slides off as well. Just sort of jamming on the brakes the last second, trying to miss him. So, Savarola's had a bit of a disastrous weekend. Things have not gone very well for him. Here's Ebenezer Quiggles Jr., the Sealander, car 999. This is the closest, or the car 99, rather. His team owner is Marcus Leonardo, who's made the 999 car legendary. One of the cars that was actually turned away for the promoter's option. As there's the Souza, man, he's got... handling problems with that double zero car they need to fix. And whoa, there goes Woodard! Greg Woodard goes off the course in the 41. As Woodard hanging on to that one, he's going to merge back onto the track safely, but he's going to lose quite a bit of track position in the Lycoya. Woodard, you can see why Lycoya has picked him up. He's got a great deal of talent, but sometimes it might not always be enough when you're aquaplaning. Here's Adrian Devereaux as he begins the Hound Zelda Ashby as we're on lap 6. Of 40. The Frenchman is really beginning to work over Ashby right now, and I might notice Ian Cooper was back there in 40th place. They have just pulled that car behind the wall. His day was done. They brought the 777 car back on track for a couple laps, but Cooper thought it wasn't safe, so they pulled it into the garage. As Adrian Devereaux now challenges Zelda Ashby for the lead of the race, and Adrian Devereaux moves into P1. As, whoa, Adrian Devereaux's having that car is pretty tail happy, but Ashby's not letting him get away. Looking back at Yamino Tenshi and Yulian Asova in the Katsev, that ruby red Katsev back there, car number 7. But Yamino Tenshi in this 25 car, definitely one of the crowd favorites, running in 5th, holding off Nasova for the time being. Yamino Tenshi in this 25 car, I mentioned earlier about the midnight car. Tenshi's been doing some fan tours along with Yulian Asova, and we could be seeing more of the Clockwork car later in the year, but I'm a little surprised Tenshi didn't get a full-time ride given her pedigree. As Melanie Cleveno skating it wide, just misses the tires there. And you really, really do not want to be in the tire wall. Melanie Cleveno using every bit of the racetrack. Battle for 8th place. Kevin Dwyer and Gaspar D'Souza. Two guys I haven't really mentioned so much today, but Kevin Dwyer is having a pretty good drive so far. And the Minnesota-born driver has gotten some flack earlier for having been in the series possibly only for his surname rather than his driving talent. Well, this should clearly be evidence to the contrary. He's really stepped it up this season, but he's got a pretty good teammate in Zach Duff as well. So Kevin Dwyer is going to have a much more difficult time beating his teammate than he did last year. I think that is but I don't think that's news to anyone. Luciano Salvarol in car number 3 is having some problems here, as looks like Chris Davenport, Lewis Kingston slowing down, Darren Cardell goes by, and Kingston, I don't know what. Oh, Melrose piles in. Oh, this is silly. Avery Holtzman, Ben Atkins just sort of piled in there, and they just created a huge wreck that didn't even need to happen. What was going on over there? I mean, I understand that it's raining out and that, you know, it might be a little harder to slow down, but that was a lot of people coming in there way too fast, I think. Anyways, visibility might not be the best, but at the same time, looks like you have to use your eyes in order to actually see that there's problems in front of you. Anyways, the O2 car, this is the FinTech team. They ran number 20 with this car last year, and they had a much better paint job on it. So, Mika Turvo is once again the driver. He's running in 33rd. The FinTech team, they're known for doing very well in the Independence Trophy, building up a massive lead at the end of the European Tour, and somehow managing to lose it. However, they're usually pretty strong with the Karjala Grand Prix, and we have a huge logjam here. Ben Atkins brings the 50 car into the pit lane. I think the damage that he kind of had it from that huge wreck was, that's going to put him out of the race, though I can't exactly blame him when he can only see the car in front of him. I think the person at the front of that huge train that sort of piled into Luciano should be the one to blame, as Turvo meets the tires. He had a pretty good run here a few years ago, did Mika Turvo, where he was running in the top 5 and then just with just a handful of laps to go threw it into that very same tire wall. So he's clearly got he clearly likes that tire wall for some reason. Here's Larson Jensen in the Blackstorm Motorsports 93 car running in 14th place as he hits the tires. He won the pole for the Team Europe race that was held yesterday and led most of the way until his teammate Andreas Laporta snuck up on him and stole the win away from him. Mika Turvo finished 3rd in that Team Europe race. So Larson Jensen trying to follow in Melanie Cleveno's steps from Team Europe full-time into the Master Cup Series. As Leonard Roderick back in 17th, working around Zach Duff and Packer Carroll, his teammate. Packer Carroll desperately needs a solid run. Roderick going wide. There's a lot of handling problems with that car. You can tell with the way he's sliding that car around. Now, there's been some rumors that Packer Carroll will, quote, voluntarily step out of the 2 car if he doesn't pick it up by Karjala, but I don't think Volpe's going to take that, especially after what happened with Alexis Rainsford, as Arto Kekkonen goes off the road. He was running in 12th, and Arto Kekkonen is, well, at least he's not hitting any walls. He's picked all the turns with huge grass runoffs to spin off, and I think that's really the most positive thing I can say about him. And that, and he set fastest lap of the race, as Leonard Roderick nearly runs into the camera post. So, Roderick seems to like that tire wall. He hit that in practice as well, but that was in the dry, so I'm not really sure what his excuse is. Yulian Asova running in 4th right now in car number 7. So, Asova beginning to slowly pull away from Davina Hinton. Now, I have to wonder, I know that the two Lynx cars, you look at the spoiler to tell them apart, but that's really not enough, I think. Anyways, Masova having a pretty strong run in the Katsev. She's really had a huge advantage over Yevgeny Kuznetsov, although the team will tell you that they don't exactly have enough money to give Kuznetsov everything he needs, and quite frankly, I'm not entirely sure I buy that, but we'll have to wait and see, I suppose. Kurt Pliskin running in 10th right now in the number 16 car for Power Stinger Incorporated. I'm not sure why they picked to bring that car here, but it's a little hard to see it, but Pliskin having a strong run. Packer Carroll is running in 12th place now, and oh, he spins it off trying to go around the outside of Avery Holtzman. And Packer Carroll is going to try to bring that car back on track. But, he's apparently got bigger problems. Packer Carroll has stopped. He's going to bring that car to a stop. He is having transmission issues with that car. So I wonder if he broke a gear and that's why the car spun off as far as it did. I'll have to wait and see what the team has to say about it. Yamino Tenshi and Davina Henton are now squabbling over 5th place. Looks like they've gotten around Yulina Sova, who's apparently gone off the track. So, we'll have to see if that's going to affect the 7 car adversely. But Davina Henton and Yamino Tenshi both having rather strong runs. Nasova as well in that 7 car. But these are a lot of drivers. I wouldn't expect to be battling for podium positions, but there's still plenty of this race left to go. The end of lap 13, car number 11 is scheduled to come in, and Davina Henton's really sliding around. Yamino Tenshi, I think, almost spun it out. Tenshi's around on pit in. So car 25 just really tried to gain some ground coming into the pit lane. Did not actually do so. So it looks like most of the field has stayed out, or most fields pitted rather, except for Adrian Devereaux, who stayed out an extra lap. The rain's coming down harder than before, and Devereaux's off! And he puts it into the tire wall. Car number one was leading the race quite comfortably, and now he's just done a whole bunch of damage to that car, trying to gain even more ground. Well, Adrian Devereaux does not normally make mistakes like this. Normally when he gets into the lead, he makes a habit of running extra hard towards the end of a run, towards the end of a stint in order to gain some ground on his rivals. And oh, Greg Woodard! Oh, why'd you do that, guys? Well, Greg Woodard, unsafe release, certainly from the 41 team, and yep, I saw that one coming. As you can see, everyone else that didn't pit on lap 13 into the pit lane as well. Looks like most of the Independence Trophy cars stayed out. Now here's the team that has been making the rest of the series look stupid in the pit lane, and that's the Double Zero team with Gasper D'Souza. He's running in second right now. A very solid second. This team gained lots of ground in the pits, and Black Diamond Racing is clearly putting the Portuguese driver in with a shot to win this race, actually. Even though Adrian Devereaux still holds the lead, it's not by as big of a margin as it was before, and D'Souza is clearly looking very, very strong right now in that Tremwell. The Kleffer Media car, very easy to see, both in the rain and in the dry, due to that distinctive bright teal that the sponsors always had on that car. And just enough, too, because it looks marvelous out here, especially kind of glows as well here, almost a little bit. Looking further back at Scott Bates in car number 88, running in 8th place. It's Yulina Sova right in front of him. Matthias Taub right behind him, running in 9th. So Taub, the Swede, having a pretty good run. So Taub was told before the season that he needed to pick up his form or that Gessler might drop him. However, clearly he's responded to all that criticism, and he's really stepped up his game for this year. He's had the advantage of Arjo Kekkonen as we look at two... English heroes here, Peter Short, the 4-time world champion, and Darren Cardell, an up-and-coming touring car driver, running 15th and 16th, both having good runs. Cardell is actually a team car to Daniel Melrose. That's a second Wernstrom, not the easiest car to see, that sort of gray and orange car, and here is Daniel Melrose, the Mad Uncle, running back in 22nd place. Cardell and Melrose are both running in the TM Lights series. This is Cardell's first Master Cup start. This is Melrose's second. And I'd say they're having a very good start to their careers so far. Chris Davenport has been in the walls a few times. Not really surprised. But he's been in the walls a couple times during the race that we haven't seen yet. but he's still in 18th place. So Davenport clearly has the speed, but he's just throwing it into the wall so often that that almost negates whatever pace he has. And who's that without a front end up there in front of him? But Davenport is kind of holding on there. He's married to former two-time Master Cup Drivers Champion Alexis Rainsford. Adrian Devereaux in car number one is going around Barton Sandy, and I think there was contact there. I think Devereaux just gave Barton Sandy a not-so-friendly nudge out of the way. The Frenchman has not exactly been very complimentary of some of the slower cars on the racetrack, because he said that they just don't give you enough space out there on track. So, Adrian Devereaux making his frustrations known there with Bart Sandy. Kevin Dwyer running in 14th place. Kevin Dwyer looks like he might have been in the wall. Whoa, he slid off! He slid it off the track! I was going to say it looked like he'd been in the wall before and that rear end looked awful light, but Dwyer's throwing it away from 14th place. Very disappointing for the young American. Matthias Taub has worked his way around. Scott Bates and Julian Osova and the Swedish driver in that gold 10 car has worked his way up to 7th. Here's a good battle that we haven't really been focusing on. It's the battle for 26th place between Vijay Pushanda in the 57 and Avery Holtzman making his first start of the year in the 3rd Tutino, car number 48. As Holtzman goes a bit wide, they have rookie stripes on that car because a local driver was supposed to drive that car, but Holtzman stepped in when they weren't able to get their license. Chris Johans in the 29 car was running a few laps down, getting in Arto Kekkonen's way, and Arto Kekkonen just very rudely shoved him off the track. I don't know why they didn't throw a penalty to Arto Kekkonen, although I think Chris Johans had been holding up the 9 car and was actually given a blue flag, but to be fair, those blue flags aren't the easiest things to see, as Adrian Devereaux laps the Togliatti, and somehow the Togliatti hasn't fallen apart, because the Togliatti made a habit of doing that last season. Togliatti has brought they bring this car to every race. It's their own car, but it's not very reliable. And it's a great bit of effort, though, by those very underslept mechanics over there. As Melanie Cleveno in car number 12 is being reeled in by Zelda Ashby in the 55. Cleveno's still holding 5th place, but Davina Henton is really charging now, as she has been rejuvenated through this last stint, and she is reeling in Gaspar D'Souza, who goes wide into the grass as the Togliatti hits the tires, and Kurt Pliskin comes close to doing likewise as Henton makes the move stick around the outside of Gaspar D'Souza. Now, I don't think D'Souza is going to be liking being passed around the outside by Henton at all, but Henton is really, really charging now. That car number 11 is one of the quickest cars on track at the moment. Adrian Devereaux, again, not happy with backmarkers. This time it's Mika Tervo, and that's another one that he's just shoved very rudely off the course. I guarantee you there's going to be a lot of people not happy with the reigning champion, especially with the way that he's treating them when he's lapping them. Kurt Pliskin having a very quiet run back in fourth place. This is a rejuvenated Kurt Pliskin that we've seen this season, and I'm using that word quite a bit, so you'll have to forgive me there, but I do mean it when I say that Kurt Pliskin has sort of his career is sort of being resurrected this season. There we go. Another long R word. Mika Tervo getting in the way of Davina Henton. This is not usual for Mika Tervo. He usually runs a lot stronger than this as he hits the tires all by himself. As Adrian Devereaux looks like his... Adrian Devereaux is really getting reeled in here by Davina Henton. He's stuck behind, I think, Ben Huron. So we'll have to wait and see how that is, but Henton really charging, and so is Gaspar D'Souza in the 00 car. They're really beginning to reel in the reigning champion, who might be wasting a lot of time with... Yeah, looks like he was being held up by Huron. So, Devereaux, now that he's gotten some clean space, is beginning to extend his lead a little bit, but not as much as he was earlier. So it looks like the Lynx team has done everything they can to make that car better as Devereaux hits the tires again! And there goes the 11 car of Henton into the lead of the race. Devereaux being a bit too ambitious there, trying to build up a gap, and now he's thrown it all away because Henton, the local driver, has gone into the lead of the race. Henton from London has gone into P1 in her home race. I don't think she can quite believe what just happened. In fact, I'm not even sure she's aware that Henton has actually gone... Oh, is Henton sliding it around, coming into pit in? Very squirrely. on pit end for her final stop. But Henton now leads the race, but Adrian Devereaux is staying out an extra lap. He's really, really rolling the dice. You can tell that Adrian Devereaux really wants to get that lead back, and he's going to try to do so on one last lap as Chris Davenport sliding it around, and Davenport into the tires as Troy Adams. Thankfully, Chris Davenport's got a very brightly colored car, so it's easy to see where he's going. But here's Chris Davenport again as he tries to enter the pit lane. Whoa! Well, remember what I said about him having a very brightly colored car? That's why Chris Davenport out of the race after having way too many dents on that car. Gaspar D'Souza beginning to reel in Henton, and that is the Ben Huron car. So D'Souza is back in third, but D'Souza's into the tires! He cooks it too hard as there's Vijay Pushyanda and Kurt Pliskin both sliding to miss the Portuguese driver. But D'Souza trying too hard to get around Henton, as now looks like he's caught, that's the other Lynx car of Melanie Cleveno here in the closing stages of this race. Gaspar D'Souza trying to make up some ground on the leaders, but now he's got a different Lynx car to get by. Melanie Cleveno is not always the easiest person to get by. Here is, as you see, D'Souza got a lot of damage to the rear end of that car. That can't be handling very well at all. In fact, I think the only two cars out there that don't have a whole bunch of damage on them are the two Lynx cars. Here, and, well, these cars, obviously. That is Darren Cardell and Zach Duff. Cardell pushing Duff wide. Duff does not have any of that, and Duff shoves Darren Cardell off the road. Very, very rudely there. But to be fair, Cardell did not give Duff any room to go at all. So I can't exactly put blame on Zach Duff for that one, because Duff, to be fair, had enough space. As Adrian Devereaux, on the other hand, is really being reeled in by Davina Henton. You can see how quickly Henton has caught him. As Henton trying to work by Adrian Devereaux, these two very similarly colored cars, just that Henton's car is much brighter colored than Devereaux's is. And it has a number 11 on it, obviously. As Adrian Devereaux gives Henton the space, there's contact between the two, and Henton moves into P1. Davina Henton moves around Adrian Devereaux, caught him without the help of any back markers, as I think all the damage that Adrian Devereaux did to that car earlier in the race is coming back to bite him, because Henton just went by, and she's beginning to pull away a little bit. So we'll have to see if Devereaux has anything left for Davina Henton in the closing stages of this one. Yamino Tenshi in the 25 car has been suffering from some damage that she suffered at the end of the first stint, I do believe. She's hanging around in sixth place as we're running on lap 29, so just a little over 10 laps to go. And she's trying to hold off. That is the 12 car of Melanie Cleveno. There is D'Souza right behind her, and this 25 car is just not the same as it was at the start of the race, but despite that, a fantastic run for the Clockwork Racing team. They should be patting themselves on the back for this one. We're looking here at the battle for 8th place between Arto Kekin, who's been off the road again, and this time looks like he's actually hit something, and Zelda Ashby as well, along with Yulina Sova in that mix as well. And Nasova's been off the road as well, so that's something we clearly missed. As looking a bit further in the background is... No, that's not who I think it is. I thought that was one of the Manicor cars. Here is Ben Huron in 26th as he slides off into the wall. As Ben Huron, car 43, a little contact there with... I do believe that was Holtzman. Leonid Roderick, oh, they've pulled the front end off the Volpe. Oh, that is a sorry-looking car right now, but... I think the sorrier thing is that that's the quickest car in the racetrack because he's off cycle, and the rain is abating just a little bit, and Roderick's car is just starting to come into its own, and he's really, really flying right now compared to everyone else. Scott Soidler in car 28 is a turbo failure, and that clearly caught the Katsev by surprise. I do believe that was Kuznetsov, because yes, that is Kuznetsov in the 8 car, but Soidler goes out from 21st place. And there you can see, right behind him was Davina Henton and Adrian Devereaux. Henton has not been able to pull away from Devereaux as much as we would have thought, because Devereaux looked like, now, Devereaux's car is getting stronger as he begins to chase Davina Henton down in the closing stages of this one. As Henton tries to hold off Devereaux for her second career Master Cup Series victory, the first race Davina Henton won, she started on pole. Ebenezer Quiggles Jr., we believe, just set fastest lap of the race in car 99. You have Jenny Kuznetsov in car number 8 is running in 21st, and he is beginning to slow on the racetrack in car number 8. Kurt Pliskin was apparently not aware of that and plowed right into the back of the Russian, and Pliskin's not happy about that, as he's going to have to pit to repair all that damage to the front end of the car, which would overheat things very quickly. And Leonard Roderick has caught the leaders, and Roderick, car number 4, is faster than the leaders. And, oh, Henton goes off. Devereaux goes off as well. So, Roderick is going to get by the two leaders. He's off cycle. He just pitted, so right now he's on fresher tires. And, oh, that car looks like a mess. But he's way, way back in the order. He's not playing too nice with Henton at the moment either. I think Roderick is employing the same strategy that Adrian Devereaux employed in Road Atlanta and trying to get 1 point. Racing really hard for it. Matthias Taub in car number 10 has worked his way to third. On that last stop, the Double Zero team of Gasper D'Souza, I mentioned that they'd been making everyone else look like fools all season. Well, that clearly didn't work this time, because they had a long stop with the Double Zero car. Here is the Arto Kekkonen in car number 9, along with Nasova and Tenchi. These three have really been going at it, but things have been sort of, they've been kind of holding station for just a little bit, as Kekkonen slides it just a little bit wide as they enter Druids, as Tenchi has a position on Nasova and Kekkonen presently. As Tenchi slides it wide, Tenchi almost into the tires, as Arto Kekkonen, car number 9, is going to... Oh, there goes Nasova off the course. So Yuli Nasova has pushed it all the way to the limit, and Nasova goes off track. Arto Kekkonen now has taken over, just taking those few places. Let's see what happens here once again with the number 7 car of Yuli Nasova. And was there no, I don't think there was any contact at all. I think Nasova just cooked the brakes a little too much, as Larson Jensen, car number 93, has really begun to work his way through the field. He hasn't really been making as many mistakes as everyone else, and he's been sort of gaining positions sort of by default, but he's not the one throwing it into the wall, so I guess you could say he's earned that one. So Larson Jensen, a lot of credit there to the young Englishman making his, I do believe, his second ever start. As Yamino Tenchi has got problems with just 2 laps to go. Looks like car 25 is beginning to slow down. 3 laps to go, sorry. Yamino Tenchi's beginning to slow down after a fantastic run with the Clockwork Racing team, and that's all gone to nothing. Very, very unfortunate for the Japanese driver, as Arto Kekkonen running in 7th, and he throws it into the tire walls. Again, there goes D'Souza. Gasper D'Souza goes by in the Double Zero car. So Arto Kekkonen, now he's going to try to push to get by D'Souza. That car has got all sorts of damage on it. Here is Larson Jensen, car number 93. We are running now, I do believe we're running now in 2 laps to go, as the 93 car coming through Druids. He's having a strong run today, and he throws it off, but not very... Oh, he's having a hard time getting it fired up. Quiggles Jr. goes by. That was for position. Quiggles Jr. has been having a very quiet but very strong race. Here's Arto Kekkonen and Gasper D'Souza on the final lap of the race. They're really, really giving it everything they've got for just outside the top 5, I do believe. We'll have to see where everything is when things shake out. But Kekkonen goes by. He slides it wide. D'Souza's going to try one last shot to get by. And D'Souza cooks it too hard, and he throws it into the tires. Gasper D'Souza tries to get everything he can. Michael Sykes runs into the Double Zero car. Michael Sykes could not avoid D'Souza, and D'Souza's going to lose 2 places there on the last lap. And someone else has been in the tires. It's Zelda Ashby. But meanwhile, back up at the pointy end of the field, Davina Henton is able to hold off Adrian Devereaux, bring it to the checkered flag, and take home her second ever TM Master Cup Series victory with a team that I didn't think was going to be fighting for wins this year. Great job by the Lynx Racing team. This is, I do believe, their first win, that team's first win since, in all of its various incarnations, since, if, correct me if I'm wrong, but Dale Roswell at Indianapolis in 2007. So talk about a long win drought for one organization. As you can see now, Adrian Devereaux and the number 10 car, Matthias Taub, rounding out the podium. Melanie Cleveneau sits there in fourth. Michael Sykes rounds out the top 5. Zelda Ashby, Yuli Nasova, Ebenezer Quiggles Jr. sneaks his way into the top 10. Arto Kekkonen in car number 9 spun off the course in the final corner and lost a couple more positions and dropped him to 10th place. Gasper D'Souza, car number 00, did not make it back to the checkered flag under his own power. And Larson Jensen, car number 93, did not either. So very disappointing for some drivers late in the race. James Davies is listed in 13th place. I don't think we showed him at all throughout the entire race because he ran a very clean race, did not really do much of anything, but that was a car that was very difficult to miss, so we apologize for not being able to show the James Davies car at any point during the race. But we do believe he'll be back for a couple other races, so if there's some James Davies fans out there, you'll get to see plenty of that car in the future. Let's have a look at the Drivers' Championship. Four races into this young season with Adrian Devereaux, the reigning champion, on top with Michael Sanks, his closest challenger. Davina Hinton having a strong start to the season in that very underpowered Lynx car. Matthias Taube, a strong fourth. Gasper Souza, Arto Kakin, and Yulia Nasova all having strong starts to their season. The two FPO drivers, Ebenezer Quiggles Jr. and Zelda Ashby, both having awesome starts to the season so far, along with Scott Bates in the 88 car in that Team EFR car. I'd also watch out for Lena Droderick and Melanie Cleveneau. And the championship, of course, Ike Durbin lost a few points after the round of Georgia. Luciano Savra, I'm surprised he's all the way down there in 14th. Very, very messy start of the season for Luciano. And, of course, Kurt Pliskin, Troy Adams, Lewis Kingston. Very close points battle there as well. Zach Duff in the 74, decent start to the season. And by the way, Daniel Melrose, big shout out to the Mad Uncle. In two races, both with the promoter's option, he sits in the top 20 in the championship. And now let's have a look at the Independence Trophy as they sit after four races. Not all the Independence Trophy cars have run, obviously, and after those penalties given to the Terra International Motorsports cars, the lead that Ike Durbin had is reduced a little bit. Jacob Eicholt still sits second, Nick Dawson still third, and of course, a couple other cars have been showing up here on the list. You'll notice Vijay Bushanda, Bart and Sandy had good starts to their Independence Trophy runs. The Tulliatti boys, Vitaly Karpenko, they had a solid race today. And that's much higher than I think anyone would have expected them to be after their first run out. The Huntley with Ben Huron, the Abbey Engineering car, also a decent start to their Independence Trophy campaign as well. But there are still many races to go. Last season, the best race, in my opinion, was held at the Circuit Thierry Secot in France. And that, my friends, is the next race on the calendar. Last year, that race was decided by a last-turn pass. We'll see if the same doesn't happen again.